Hey everyone, Mark the Movie Man here. Welcome to The Final Cut. We're going to look at an independent horror film today, making the festival circuit this season, and we're talking about Hazmat. Brought to us by Lou Simon, who wrote, directed, and produced this. She was the one that brought us The Awakened last year at the Madison Horror Film Festival. Well, now we've got Hazmat, the story about a television crew for a show called Scary Antics. And Scary Antics is basically a show where people come to them and say, hey, I've got a friend who I want to scare the hell out of. And Scary Antics is, sure. So they set up the situation and the scene and the actors, and they take the, you know, they videotape it all through CCTV and regular video cameras to broadcast on national television. Well, when Scary Antics crew gets a hold of a group of people who want to scare and help their friend, Jacob, who's a disturbed guy who just can't get over the fact that his father died in this chemical factory, and that said chemical factory, he believes, is haunted. Well, Scary Antics can't pass this up, and so they help convince Jacob that the place is haunted and put him on the show. Well, tables get turned, things go awry, and pretty soon the group of friends, as well as the TV crew, are finding they're the ones being scared as they're being chased by an axe-wielding maniac in a hazmat suit and a gas mask. Folks, Hazmat is a send-up to the old-school slasher films. Had that feel to it, and I loved it. From the music, from Michael Damon's music, set the feeling of the whole film to the look of it. They got this location where they filmed it. I don't know if it was an actual abandoned chemical factory or just a warehouse, but whatever it is, it was abandoned, and there was a lot of crap in the rooms, and definitely it had an authentic, creepy feeling. Loved the setting. All these different rooms were like mazes, and definitely helped out. Plus, with the lack of windows, things got very dark, which leads me to the camera work in this was done so well. I loved it. They did a lot of visual things, like at one point, and it's not a spoiler, but at one point the axe-wielding hazmat guy has a light on his head, and it's completely dark, and so you get to see just his head movement, and it's really cool how they do that. Some great visuals in this. The camera work, really well done, and it's great to see them move from The Awakened, which is kind of a smaller project, to one house to something a little bigger location with a lot more stuff going on. Lou Simon has definitely grown and improved on her directing, and I really enjoyed how she paced this film and what she wrote. The story was cool. Now, in a slasher film, you know, you won't get a huge amount of originality, but I did like the fact that they played the TV angle. I also like the fact that it's not a found footage film, but they did give some views from the CCTV camera was going on, and then what was actually going on, you know, you're right there in the hall, and then you get the CCTV camera. And the way she jumped between those really helped build some tension in some of the scenes where you're like, he's right on top of you. You can see it through the CCTV camera. And then you cut to a completely black hallway where you see the person standing there. And you know the guy's behind her because you saw the CCTV camera. So definitely some great juggling there with the editing, okay? Not too many things wrong with this film that I could find. There is some decent special effects in here. Not a huge amount of gore. I would have probably liked to see a little more blood. But where it's used properly, and it looked great, okay? It really looked well, and for a project of this budget, the gore effects definitely there. Lots of practical. Thank you for the practical blood effects. I didn't really have a whole lot of problems with this film, except for maybe the chemistry between the people, Jacob and his friends, okay? Now, the chemistry between the TV crew was fantastic. These actors really came across like they had been working together for a while, and you got that feeling, and it came across. They were a close-knit group, and you could feel that there was actually some feelings there. Now, between the friends and Jacob, not so much. The one character is supposed to be really close and tight with his buddy, even though his buddy's going through some rough times, and he's been kind of distant. But I never quite felt that connection between those characters. It felt just a little bit like they had too many problems of why they'd be together. And then the Jacob character, who was a little more enthusiastic. You know, they did these interviews with the characters and set him up and set up this Jacob character as being a really sad and kind of depressed emo type of guy. But he was pretty enthusiastic and excited when he got to the chemical plant. So little bit of, you know, not misdirection, but I just felt they could have been set up a little bit better. But other than that, I really enjoyed Hazmat. It's a lot of fun. Slasher film fans, as well as those fans of independent horror or independent cinema, need to catch Hazmat at a local festival near you when it comes out. Also, keep an eye out. I hope they get distribution, because I think everybody really needs to deserve to see this little independent horror film called Hazmat. And that'll about do it for us here at the Final Cut. Till next time, keep that ticket stub.